juices.
Hey everyone, I'm Steph. Chris is behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We are in the coastal city of Zamboanga, located in the western Mindanao region of the Philippines. Now, the food here is really unique and quite different than the rest of the country, so we have a big, exciting day of eating planned ahead of us. We're so hungry. I can't wait to get this day started, so come on, let's get to it. Starting off our day here at Jimmy's Satti for a very popular breakfast here in the Mindanao region, satay. This looks really good, so come on, let's check out what they're cooking. They have three different kinds of satay here. We've got the chicken, the chicken liver, and the beef. So we're definitely gonna need to try all three of them. They look and smell so good with the red sauce that they've picked it. The tamo, the rice wrapped in coconut leaves. It's really heavy though, actually. That's some dense rice. So here we've got the empty box for the rice. So this is what they cook the puso in. And they just showed us how fast they are at making them, which is fantastic. But look at these, it smells nice. Actually, just green of the coconut leaf. And so there's a little compartment here that just opens up. And so they're saying, so this is where they put the raw rice in, and they just fill it just less than halfway, and then they close it back up, and then pop it in boiling water and just let it boil. So the rice actually boils and expands inside of this, and then it makes it nice and compact for the puso. Here she does, has a whole pile of them that she's cutting up afterwards. You can see it's such a nice little dense, compact package of rice. It's gonna be good.
Here we've got the chicken to try. We got a drumstick as well as a thigh. These look like good pieces. We've got the chicken liver to try, as well as these little beef guys here. And they have all been soaked in the sweet, spicy gravy. And we've got our puso, which is called tamo here in Zamboanga, which is that really dense rice. Look at that. I'm gonna start with the sauce and give that a taste because there's just so much of it. It's like a soup. Look how thick and sticky the sauce looks. Look at that. And the color of it, that orange color, is from the anito, which is very orangey. Look at that. Ooh. Oh, wow, okay. Is spicy. The first taste of it is very much like a gravy. It almost has like a beefy gravy flavor to it. But as soon as you get that first swallow and it hits the back of your throat, it is spicy. There's a lot of pepper spice in here, as well as garlic and onion. It's so flavorful. It really is just like a soup that you could honestly just drink on its own. Let's get one of these tamos to try though. Very dense. You almost can't distinguish between one piece of rice and the next. It's just very compact. But it goes really well with that sauce because the gravy just soaks right into it. That's good. Okay, let's dig into this meat now. Look at that chicken liver there. It's already been marinated in a nice red sauce, so I think this should be really flavorful. A little sweetness to it. The chicken liver is cooked very well, nice and soft and mushy like a chicken liver is, but it's also a bit hard too because it's been grilled, so it has a nice outer texture to it that's a bit tougher. good together when you really get that flavor of the tango and the sauce. Look at the size of this chicken drumstick. It's a big guy.
So saucy.
So saucy. Definitely gonna give it loads of dips. Okay, here we go. That red marinade. Oh, and it's nice and sweet and rich, and with that spicy sauce on the outside, honestly it gives it such a nice dimension of flavor because you've got the sweet and the spicy. Chicken is definitely the way to go. And the char on the outside and the smokiness of the grill, that is delicious. Look how juicy and tender this meat is. Just cooked to perfection there. Oh, I love this sauce so much. Last but not least, we've got our little beef guys here. Look at that. So each one has about 3 cubes of beef on it. You can see there. Look at that sauce just dripping off. It's so thick and sticky. Oh. That beef is nice. It's tender. Because the pieces are so small, it really soaks up the flavor of the sauce. Nice and smoky and charred from the grill. Satti is a very popular Filipino Muslim breakfast, and Jimmy Satti has been around since 1976, so it's become quite an institution here in Zamboanga. You can find Satti at loads of restaurants around the city, but if you're looking for a place to try it when you're here in Zamboanga, we highly recommend you coming here to Jimmy Satti, because their satti really is delicious. That was the perfect breakfast. So next door they have something we've been looking for here in Zamboanga called lokot. So let's give it a taste. Here it is. So this is lokot, and it's a very popular Filipino Muslim dessert. Now it's really popular for special occasions like weddings or Eid, and just look at how intricate it is. It's rice flour that has been put into half a coconut shell with a bunch of holes, and it's poured into boiling oil, and it creates a mat, and then they use wooden spoons to roll the mat into this shape here, and it's so delicate. There's so many strands. All right, let's give it a try. Oh, that is super, super crunchy. Look at that. That's so dense inside with all the strands. It's a little bit sweet. That is very tasty, quite flavorful. Light, super crunchy. Mash it up. Very delicious. Very delicious. Very nice light dessert. I can see why this is popular. I feel like this would be really good, like dipped in ice cream or something like that.
The lady said have it with coffee.
Coffee would be very good to put it in. I could see that. It's gonna taste a little treat. Very nice. Just listen to this crunch. This would be a nice snack the rest of the day.
Peanut butter.
Yeah.
Wow.
So we are here at Reika's Resto to try a very popular Filipino stew. Now this is Papaitan kambing, which is a bitter goat stew. Now what makes this stew so bitter is the use of bile from the goat that makes it bitter, as well as it gives it this nice green color. And as well inside, it's just full of goat innards like the lungs, tripe, the kidneys. So this looks like a very hearty stew. Let's give it a mix here. Oh man, you can see how full this bowl is with the goat innards. You can see the carpety tripe there, the kidney, intestines, and lungs. Might as well start with an ultimate bitter goat stew bite here. Lots of offal in there. Mmm, quite chewy too. To be honest, it's not very bitter. I don't really taste the bitter taste to it. Mmm, that's really tasty. A bit sour from the calamansi, but honestly, there's no bitter flavor. I don't really taste that bitter of a flavor. All the offal, nice and soft and a bit chewy. Mmm. You can see here, there's actually pieces of goat with the skin on there as well. It's got a slight intestine offal taste to it, but to be honest, it's very, very mild, not strong. And again, the smell, it just smells like the calamansi. And he did put actually a spoon of peanut butter when he was mixing it, so the broth is actually super flavorful. The use of the peanut butter makes it a little bit creamy and just rich as well. So it does have a lot of flavor.
Judith.
Yeah.
Masarap.
Masarap.
Oh, it's very tasty, very delicious. Oh, super, super yummy. Oh, I love it. I know Steph isn't a big fan of offal, so I wanted to try this one, but I think we should give her a try.
Okay, my turn. I'm definitely a little apprehensive because there is a lot going on in this stew. Bottoms up. A lot of interesting textures going on there. Flavor-wise, there's definitely a few chunks of meat, which is nice. Okay, it's not too bad. It's just a little chewy, soft. There's some like gelatinous textures in there. Oddly enough, like Chris said, it's not super bitter or anything like that, which is nice. It's kind of creamy. Mostly the calamansi flavor of it is there. Not too awfully. You know what? I really like this broth because it's actually quite meaty tasting. You know what? I think I kind of like this.
Yay, she likes it.
And the owner of the restaurant here, her name is Judith, and she is so incredibly nice. She saw that we were finishing our bowl of stew here, and she wanted to top us off with some more Papaitan kambing. And she was actually telling us as well that the reason why this goat stew is not bitter is because it's a local Zamboangan version of the goat stew. And if you have it in Luzon, kind of close to Manila in that region, then the goat stew can be a little bit more bitter, but this version, ingredient packed and just really, really flavorful.
Clamato, muchas gracias. Oh, thank you so much. It was so, so delicious. Masarap. Oh, it was amazing.
Sambroso.
Sambroso.
Yeah.
Today is so different than the rest of the country. It's known as Chabacano cuisine, and it has just so many different flavors and tastes than you find in the rest of the Philippines. It's been such a treat eating here and also just walking around. To be honest, the city is really walkable. There's quite a few sights to see, so Zamboanga is definitely a place to visit.
We've got our mango gram here to cool off, which legit is mango smoothie with graham cracker crumbs. So it's like graham powder. We've got fresh mango, two different kinds of milk. I think it was condensed milk and like an evaporated milk, ice.
It looks smells pretty good.
Yeah. Yeah, it does. It smells
mango-y,
really
grammy.
Looks really refreshing.
This is a mango gram.
Let's do it. Sure. Each got a little straw here.
All right.
Let's lady in the tramp.
Cheers. Cheers. That is refreshing.
It's actually a really strong flavor of mango. Oh, that is so nice and refreshing. And it's ice cold too. They put a good chunk of ice in there.
A graham cracker adds a nice bit of crackery sweetness to it. Yeah, that adds a nice dimension to a mango shake, yeah.
Oh, it does actually. I do love graham cracker things, and that does give a nice flavor to it. Mm. I was thinking it might be kind of like weird, or if it would go soggy or something like that, but it doesn't actually. That's really nice, interesting.
It honestly works well, the graham cracker and the mango. Mm.
So refreshing.
Lokot. That's tasty.
Oh, I have to win.
Local delicacies. One of the most popular and best seafood restaurants in the city to try a very rare Zamboanga specialty. This should be good. So we are here at Alabar Seafood Restaurant for the very special rare CURACHA crab. Now this is a deep sea crab, a very rare deep sea crab that is found around this region here in Zamboanga, and it is very special. You can see the color of it here already, that they're already like that red orange color, but they're not cooked yet. So they're so different than normal mud crabs that you find. You can see their claws are very, very small as well. All the meat of the actually in the body. So we've heard this is kind of like a mixture between a giant sea crab and a spiny lobster. You can tell by the color that it does look good, and we are lucky enough to go see the preparation of it with the special Alabar sauce, which this restaurant is very, very well known for. Just see how thick these CURACHA crabs are. They're so much wider and thicker than your normal mud crab. You can see there, it has like the crustacean tail of a lobster almost there. So just so special and so different, unique, and rare, these crabs.
We will cut it in half.
That's a small size that they sell here at Alabar Restaurant. This is an extra large crab here. Wow, look at all that meat inside the crab there. So the crabs are gonna get boiled first. Special Alabar sauce.
Then mix it together. Cut into two.
Oh, you can smell that sauce too. Wow. So you see the special Alabar sauce that they're cooking CURACHA with? That is a signature Alabar seafood restaurant sauce. CURACHA crab is so interesting because it is a deep sea crab. They aren't farmed, so you can't farm the crab, and they're also found just deep in the sea as well. So this is amazing. They have suppliers that provide them with all the crabs. Such a rare experience and just so special to be trying this CURACHA crab here in Zamboanga. So we are here at Alabar Seafood Restaurant. This is the owner here, Jamari. He's the third generation owner, and the business manager, Sir Mario. So they are both going to explain to us how to eat the special Zamboanga CURACHA crab, and then their special Miguel sauce chicken as well. And look at the spread here too. We have the delicious chicken with the special Miguel sauce there, as well as this beautiful seafood spread here. We have the CURACHA crab here with the special Alabar sauce that they are very, very known for here, as well as all over the Philippines. And we have some, looks like squid, shrimp, some clams, some beautiful rice, and fish. Wow, grilled fish at the end there too. So this is a seafood feast here at Alabar Restaurant.
We've been here for 58 years. I'm the third generation who handles the business. This is the first time you're gonna be featured the Migos chicken sauce.
Yes.
Yeah.
the first time in 58 years that we're gonna show this to the public that we have this innovative, we innovated this sauce for chicken, really.
Yeah, so this is kind of like the Alavar sauce, but new Miguel sauce for chicken.
More
specifically for chicken.
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, wow. So this is very, very special experience. Vinegar.
It's vinegar.
Good?
Yes. All right. Mm-hmm.
Seafood rice here. Wow, look at that. And Jamari was saying that it's made with the crab juices, which gives it that beautiful orange color there. Look at that.
You get the crab?
Okay, let's get a close-up of this too. So yeah. Here is the Curacha crab.
It's basically, you can see the fat of the crab. You do your hands like this, and then put the sauce on the rice.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, and then let's add this. It's perfect.
Is that some more Alavar sauce?
This is more Alavar sauce.
Ah, okay.
Or the fat of the crab, it's very fat.
Oh wow, look at that.
Yeah. Dip it with your vinegar. Okay. Right. More messy, more good.
Right. Yeah, we love eating with our hands.
All right.
All right.
There you go. It's perfect, right?
Oh, oh wow. Mmm. That sauce is like so creamy and coconutty. Oh my god. And that piece of crab, so meaty, honestly like melts in your mouth. Nice, perfect flavor of crab. Wow. But that sauce, that sauce I think is the star. Mmm. The rice as well. Very, very rich rice. Oh, this is amazing. I'm gonna dig in to this crab and try to get more meat out of here.
Ooh, that's rice.
Oh, look at those juices. Wow. Oh, those crab juices. Amazing. Oh, wow. Look at that meat there. Super meaty. So tender, look at that, just falling out.
Now you eat it with rice.
And I like the use of the raisins as well. It's a nice sweet touch too. Mmm, that crab is so, so good. Got Alavar sauce, oh, so good. Sir Mario, masarap, sambroso.
Si,
sambroso. Delicious. Look at all the meat on this crab. And let's get a little dip.
How do you find the
Alavar sauce?
The curacha and the sauce. Is it?
Oh, the sauce is just so coconutty, so flavorful and rich and just slightly sweet, but just creamy and honestly delicious. Almost buttery flavor. Mmm. Mmm. Oh. And I think the crab as well is a juicier than normal crab that I've eaten before.
The sauce, you can only find the ingredients in Zamboanga. So actually it's just basically coconut milk and different secret spices that you can only find in Zamboanga. You cannot find the ingredients of the sauce anywhere in the world, but only in Zamboanga.
Okay, so it's pure coconut milk with their special spices.
Yeah.
Oh. And you can really taste the coconut.
Yeah.
That's what makes it. And we love coconut. And it's such a different flavor than other Filipino food with the use of the coconut milk, right? Yeah.
Wow. Well, I bet you to try our baked lamb sauce, our famous garlic sauce.
So you can see the garlic sauce in there, baked to perfection.
There it goes.
Mmm. Nice and garlicky. My favorite. I love garlic. Those clams are so juicy. Amazing.
You should also try our squid. This famous also here in Alavar. Here you go.
Look at that. Oh, it's stuffed. It's a stuffed squid.
It's a stuffed squid and there's some beef inside.
Wow, look at that.
There you go.
Mmm.
It's nice, right?
Very garlicky on the inside as well. Squid, not too chewy, just cooked again to perfection. And a little bit of this sauce. Mm, it's like sweet, almost like a sweet teriyaki sauce on there. Mm.
We also have the fish belly, a special fish that you can only find in the wet market of Zamboanga.
Okay.
You have to dip it with your vinegar.
Can I dip it in the Alavar sauce?
You can. Okay.
See how meaty that is, that fish belly? Wow.
You have to eat it with rice, okay?
Mmm. Mmm.
It's nice, right?
Very smoky.
Small.
Mmm. Mmm. The fish is really tender, fatty. Mmm. Flavor is amazing. And it has a char. That char taste.
Try with the Alavar sauce.
Mm. I think we're gonna need more Alavar sauce on this table.
Alright.
Alright.
There you go. I'm sure your audience will be hungry already. Oh. They watch your vlog, you know.
Okay.
think I can dip anything in the olive oil sauce and it'd be good. Exactly. Rice, seafood, chicken, beef, pork, anything.
There you go.
Mmm, the vinegar, very powerful vinegar flavor, but brings out the taste of the shrimp there.
Actually, it's actually coconut vinegar. It comes from our farm.
Oh, gotta suck out the shrimp head, like Jamari said.
There you go. Holy
That's delicious. This is a seafood feast, but I think Steph is gonna have to try the Miguel sauce chicken, so let's give it a little switch.
I was getting pretty hungry, I must say, watching Chris eat all that food, so I'm excited to try this chicken here.
You have to put all the rice on your plate.
Ah, okay, take the whole thing. There we go.
All right. You have to squeeze your hands like this with your rice.
Okay.
Go. There you go. While squeezing it, I'm gonna pour the chicken sauce on your rice.
Okay.
There you go. So before you try the chicken, you have to try first our Miguel's chicken sauce by Alomar.
All right. Mmm. Oh my god.
Okay,
that is delicious. It's so creamy and coconutty. Yes. That's what you can really taste. Mmm. Such a nice flavor though. It's like a little bit sweet.
Yes. Filipino loves, you know, sugary sauce in their plates. So as they always say, the sauce, it's already completely rice, but you have to also try the roasted chicken.
Yeah, you're right. Like, you could just eat the rice and the sauce and you'd be happy to be honest.
So basically, this is the sauce. It's the pack sauce. This is the 1/4 size sauce. There you go.
Miguel's chicken sauce.
Yes.
Oh, look at this piece.
There you go.
That's a huge one.
That roast chicken looks so good.
Look at that.
Make sure it's dirty on your mouth. That's how you enjoy it. Perfect with chicken, eh?
Mmm. Oh, so good with the chicken.
So do.
It's just so rich and creamy, to be honest, especially with all that coconut flavor. Mmm. It goes so well with the chicken. Yes. That is perfect. Mmm. The chicken itself is roasted lovely. Nice and tender and juicy. Mmm.
That's the Alomar way of cooking, ma'am.
Tender and juicy.
Yes.
I like it. Let's try some more of this sauce with the rice.
There you go.
Gotta get messy. Mmm. Oh, it just soaks into the rice so well. That was delicious. That's it up.
More of the chicken sauce.
Oh yeah. I like that you're not shy with the sauce. I like that.
Because it's good. Because it's really good.
It is. And see just how thick and creamy that sauce is. Let's pour a bit on there. Oh wow, look at that. Mm-hmm. Oh, that is incredible. Mmm. Oh yeah. That was delicious. I can't get over how rich and flavorful that is. Mmm. That's perfect.
Perfect rice with chicken.
Perfect, yeah. Oh man, I don't know what else to say. It's delicious.
So this feast has been amazing. You can see we have pretty much finished the chicken, all of the seafood platter, definitely the crab, all of it is gone. And we finished all of the Miguel sauce. We have only, this is the second bowl that we've had of the Alomar sauce here. So we only have a little bit left, but to be honest, you can just drink it on its own. It's so good, you could probably put it with anything. Wow, what an experience here. Honestly,
thank you so much.
Jamari and Sir Mario, thank you so much. Muchas gracias. The food was sabroso. Masarap, all the delicious. Thank you so much. Thank you very much. Definitely visit Alomar Seafood Restaurant if you're ever in Zamboanga. Try the Curacha, try the chicken with the Miguel sauce, try all their menu items. It's all delicious.
Your trip would not be complete without dining at Alomar Seafood
Restaurant. No, and that's their saying. So you have to dine at Alomar Seafood Restaurant when you come to Zamboanga because it's not complete unless you do. Thank you again. Thank you so much. That's it for our food tour here in Zamboanga City. Thank you so much for watching. The food has been incredible, but the people and the hospitality, especially at Alomar Seafood Restaurant, have been amazing. If you're interested in any of the restaurants that we've been to today, then hit the description box below for all the info. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, give it a thumbs up, and make sure you subscribe to our channel to keep caught up on all of our food adventures. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.